following film contains graphic violence and material that may not be suitable for younger viewers. Parental discretion is advised.
It's gonna be terrible!
Hey, what's up, ghouls and gals? It's me, Righty here, and it's Saturday night! Alright, guys, let's get into it. I'm gonna review Ghost Ship. Alright, guys, Ghost Ship stars all these lovely people right here.
Yo-ho, 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 yo-ho. So try the life of a thief.
All right, let me tell you what Ghost Ship's about. Oh God, where do I start? It's about a lot of stuff. Ghost Ship's about, obviously, some ghosts on a ship, hence the name of the movie. But it's also about a gold heist. It's also about a demonic entity. It's also about a crew of salvagers being shipwrecked. And it's also about some ghosts that need to be liberated to go into heaven. There's a lot of things going on, guys. A lot of plots going on, and Ghost Ship doesn't really know how to deal with all those plot lines. But we'll get into that a little bit later. Ghost Ship starts off really strong. This movie has to have one of the most impressive opening scenes I've ever seen in a movie. It starts off with this magnificent scene right here. Yeah, wasn't that just fucking awesome? Like, even though that was shot, like, almost 20 years ago, it was shot, like, in 2002, it looks magnificent. It looks really good. It's well shot. It's just, it's awesome. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful scene. It's a beautiful scene. Unfortunately, the movie, it struggles to stay afloat after that. It does not keep up that pace whatsoever. It, no pun intended, it just ultimately sinks. Yeah, this film, like I said earlier, it has a bunch of plot lines and it kind of doesn't know what to do with all of those plot lines when this film could have just had the one singular plot line of just there being ghosts on the ship and just explain why those ghosts are on that ship. I mean, it would have been perfectly fine if they would have just kept the whole thing of like, okay, these people got killed on this boat, that's why they're on this boat, and they got killed because of the gold. That's fine. Right there. Those two plot points. Boom. That's fine. Awesome. If you just had that, that would have been perfecto. Awesome. I would have been like, hey, it's not that bad of a movie. Because when this movie started off, like I said, I was like, oh shit. Okay. Yeah. Look, this is my play-by-play reaction of fucking Ghost Ship. It started off something like this. Oh, come on, are you serious? Yes, that was my literal play-by-play reaction of Ghost Ship. That's exactly how I'm sure a lot of you will feel when you go and revisit this film. I know this film, for a lot of you horror fans out there, is like a nostalgic film because a lot of y'all grew up with this film, but I really suggest you take off those nostalgia glasses and watch this movie just with sober eyes, so to speak, and you'll really see what I'm talking about. This movie, it is a muddled mess. I mean, it's a horror movie without any real horror, to be honest with you. The villain of the film, this guy right here, he's laughable. It's just, it's stupid what they do with him. Instead of just, like I said, going with see those two plot lines of like the gold and this is why this is why these people died and this is why they're haunting that ship or whatever. They instead go a really weird route, and they make this guy the villain, and he's some sort of demonic entity that is going around, that went around branding people before the ship sank, and now he owns their souls and he controls them inside of the boat and stuff. And I was just like, oh my god, are we serious? Are we really doing this? And at the end of the movie, it doesn't really even have an ending, because this movie does the early 2000 thing and it like leaves itself open for a sequel that's never gonna fucking happen because nobody wants a fucking sequel to Ghost Ship. One thing I can say about this film is that it uses a lot of practical effects, which I like, which that's cool, because the CGI in this film, oh god, did it age terribly bad. It looks like PS2 level graphics, some of the CGI in this film. But again, it was 2002 and they worked with what they had. But I mean, maybe trying to do a whole CGI boat wasn't a good idea, but I digress. That isn't the film's biggest problem. The film's biggest problem is the film itself. Like I said, it juggles too many balls, so to speak, and it ends up just sucking those balls. The film, what can I rate this film? I'm gonna rate this film low, because it doesn't even have what Serenity had, where it was so bad that it was good. This film just ended up being so bad that it was bad. I mean, it's just kind of a run-of-the-mill, boring film that, I mean, if you really want to revisit it, I mean, after this review, I mean, go ahead and do it. But, I mean, I really wouldn't suggest just going to watch it, because it's like, oh, yeah, a Ghost Ship, it's so super awesome. It's, like I said, a mediocre film. I give it a 4 out of 10, guys, and I hope you like this movie review, and I'll see you in the next one. Thank you.